OctoPrint is an awesome piece of open source software that on a basic level gives you the ability to monitor and control your 3D printer. But over the past few years, OctoPrint has gotten much more sophisticated. It now has a whole suite of plugins that include a mobile app to monitor and control your printer from anywhere, mesh bed level visualization, AI failure detection, awesome time-lapse video creation, and a whole lot more. With OctoPrint, you can customize your workflow just about any way you like. In this video, I'll show you how to set it up on a Raspberry Pi, and then we'll install some of my favorite OctoPrint plugins. Let's get into it. As I mentioned, OctoPrint is a great, free, and open source software created and maintained by Gina Hoyska. I would consider it one of the best upgrades for your 3D printer. Once connected to OctoPrint, you'll be able to easily monitor and control your 3D printer and take advantage of the awesome plugins I mentioned earlier. So what do you need to get started with OctoPrint? First, you'll need a Raspberry Pi. While just about any Pi will work, it's best to use a Raspberry Pi 3 or 4. The new 02W also works as well. OctoPrint can also be run on other devices like an old computer or an Android phone, but a Raspberry Pi, assuming you can get your hands on one, is the easiest way to get started. Today, I'll be using a Raspberry Pi 4 with 2 gigs of RAM. You will also need an SD card, class 10 or better, and you'll want at least 8 gigabytes of storage. I'd recommend more if you plan to store a lot of G-code files or time-lapse videos. You also need a 5-volt, 2.5-amp power supply, and it needs to be a high-quality one. The Raspberry Pi 4B uses a USB-C. You can also use your printer's power supply to power the Raspberry Pi, but we won't cover that in this video. You also need a USB cable to connect the Raspberry Pi to your printer. One probably came with your printer, so check around if you have that. It's also recommended that you get some heat sinks to prevent overheating the Pi. You might want a case as well, but of course you can always just 3D print one. Lastly, you will want a camera. A USB webcam or Raspberry Pi camera is recommended. In this video, I'll be using a Logitech C920. First, let's get the software set up. Take the SD card and insert it into your computer. Now download the Raspberry Pi imager from raspberrypi.org/software. This software is available for both Windows and Mac. Once it's downloaded, go ahead and install and run the Raspberry Pi imager. Select Choose OS and select Other Specific Purpose OS. Then select OctoPi. This will automatically download the latest version of the OctoPi image from octoprint.org. Under Choose Storage, select the SD card that you want to install OctoPrint on. Make sure you don't have any important files on this SD card, as it will be wiped. Don't click Write yet. You'll want to secure your Pi and configure the Wi-Fi first. By default, the password to SSH into your OctoPi instance is Raspberry and the username is Pi. This is not very secure, so you'll want to change that password to prevent possible attacks from malicious users. To do this, just press Ctrl+Shift+X to bring up the Raspberry Pi Imager Advanced Options menu. Click Enable SSH and enter a secure password for the Raspberry Pi user. The username is Pi and the password is the one you just created. Connect your Raspberry Pi to the internet. If possible, connect your Pi directly to your wireless router with an Ethernet connection, but I know most of you won't be able to do that, so I'll show you how to set up the Wi-Fi on the Raspberry Pi. With the Raspberry Pi imager and the secret options menu, Wi-Fi configuration is a breeze. Simply enter your username and password under Configure Wi-Fi. Be careful, this entry is space and case sensitive, so enter the username and password exactly as it appears on your router. Under the country code section, choose the country that you're in. Don't forget this part. Click Save and then click Write. Once complete, eject the SD card from your computer. Now it's time to connect the hardware. Connect the heat sinks to the Raspberry Pi if you have them. Remember, all of the heat sinks should face the same direction. Now put the Raspberry Pi in the case. Next, plug the printer cable into the Pi. Now Now plug the power cable into the Pi. If you're using a Raspberry Pi 4, it's a USB-C power adapter. Next, connect the webcam or a Raspberry Pi cam. If you're using a USB webcam, connect the webcam by plugging the USB cable into any of the USB ports on the Raspberry Pi. If you're using a Raspberry Pi camera, place the ribbon cable into the camera and the Pi as shown. Be very careful with the cable, it's pretty fragile. Now plug the ribbon cable into the Pi. The blue side of the cable should be facing away from the HDMI port. There are many different ways to mount your camera. 3D printed mounts, tripods, webcam arm mounts, or even old boxes will all work. In this example, I'm using a mini tripod that came included with the Logitech camera. Now, let's turn on your 3D printer if it isn't already. Plug the printer cable into your 3D printer and plug the power cable into a power outlet. At this point, the Raspberry Pi should be powered on, connected to the internet, and your 3D printer. Now, let's access the OctoPrint user interface. To do this, open a web browser on your computer and type http://octopi.local into the URL bar. This should bring you right into the OctoPrint login screen, but if this does not work, you'll need to locate your OctoPi's IP address. You can do this in a few different ways. On a Windows computer, you can open the File Explorer and click Network tab. This should show you an OctoPi instance. You can click that to show you the IP address. If you have network sharing disabled, you'll need to turn that on in order to see your Pi in the Network tab. Another option is to find your IP address through your home Wi-Fi router settings. If you don't know how to do this, you'll need your router username and password, which might be different from your Wi-Fi password, and you'll need to know your router's IP address. If you don't know it, PC Mag has a great article on accessing your Wi-Fi router's settings. Once you're able to access the OctoPrint interface, follow the on-screen instructions to complete the setup wizard. You'll want to set your printer's build volume and nozzle diameter in the printer profile section. Note, this information does not change any slicer-related G-code settings or anything like that. It only changes the controls within OctoPrint. Now, it's time to install some plugins. One of the greatest features of OctoPrint is its open source plugin system. In the plugin manager, you can install plugins for visualizing how level your bed is, creating magic like time lapses, catching failures using AI failure detection, remote monitoring controlling your printer from outside your home network, and a whole lot more. Let's start by installing our favorite OctoPrint plugin, Obico for OctoPrint. With this plugin, I'll be able to monitor and control my printer from anywhere on any device. There's a mobile app for iOS and Android that lets me check the printer's live webcam stream, start and stop prints, get print status notifications, and get added peace of mind with AI failure detection. When needed, I can even access the full OctoPrint interface from anywhere. To install Obico for OctoPrint, open up OctoPrint and click Settings. Find the Plugin Manager tab and then click Get More. Search for Obico for OctoPrint. Click Install and just let the plugin install. That's basically how you will install any OctoPrint plugin. Most plugins will require some sort of configuration once they're installed. To configure Obico for OctoPrint, follow the plugin wizard that will pop up once the plugin is installed. Quick side note on pricing, as I'm sure some of you are wondering. Obico has a free plan that is 100% free for one printer. It gives you unlimited print monitoring, but has some frame rate limitations for the free version and limited AI failure detection. But you can always add more AI failure detection hours if you want. The Pro plan starts at $4 per month and gives you some awesome added features that you can try out for free since Obico drops you into a 30-day free trial right when you sign up. You can try all the features and upgrade or not at the end of the trial. If you don't upgrade, your account will just get converted to a free plan. In addition to the different Obico cloud plans, Obico is 100% open source. So if you have the technical chops, including some Linux and networking knowledge, you can configure and self-host your own Obico server using your own hardware. I'll include a link to the GitHub repository with more information below. You can install Obico for OctoPrint using the mobile app or on the Obico website. I'll go with the mobile app for now. Download the mobile app if you haven't already. Once downloaded, go ahead and create an account. Once you've created an account, you can link your 3D printer with the Obico Cloud. If you're self-hosting, you can still take advantage of the Obico mobile app and other features by linking your self-hosted server. Click Link Printer. If this is your first time linking your printer, Obico will automatically identify your Raspberry Pi and ask you if you want to connect. If the automatic link doesn't work for some reason, click Link Manually. Now go back to the OctoPrint page that you had open, click Next on the Setup Wizard, and enter the code from the Obico mobile app. Once your printer is connected, you can use the mobile app to check in on your prints, test out the AI failure detection, get print status notifications, and more. And of course, you can always access the full OctoPrint interface safely and securely from anywhere with the OctoPrint tunneling feature on your phone or desktop computer. Now that we have Obico set up, I'll share a few of my favorite OctoPrint plugins. OctoPrint's print time estimations can sometimes be way off. Print Time Genius is a simple plugin that gives you accurate print time estimates that are up to date. I'd highly recommend installing this plugin. Octolapse is one of my favorite plugins. It gives you the ability to make these amazing time-lapse videos that look like the print is growing out of nowhere. Teaching Tech has a great video on Octolapse, so I'll link to that above. Another great plugin, if you tend to print plates of parts or really any time you're printing with more than one part on the build plate, is the Exclude Region plugin. With this plugin, if one part gets knocked off the bed, but the others look like they will print fine, you can exclude the region where the part fell off and then let the rest of the parts keep printing. The first step of installing any of these plugins will be the same as installing the Obico plugin, but as I mentioned before, each plugin will have its own requirements to get configured properly. Many of the plugins have really good documentation to help you get started. You can explore plugins directly in the Plugin Manager with OctoPrint, or you can find more details about them in the plugin repository on octoprint.org, which I'll link to below. There's a ton of other OctoPrint plugins I haven't mentioned, so definitely let me know if there's a specific one that you love and can't live without. Well, thanks for watching this video. If you enjoyed it, please give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing to get notified about future videos. Goodbye.